Hey, what's up, YouTube? I'm Zeke, and welcome to the Dream Green Show. In this episode, we're going to talk about the stock Netflix. Now, Netflix recently just had an earnings call, and their stock pretty much crashed in a matter of around 30 minutes. They announced during the earnings call that they did not meet expectations on subscriber growth rate. Now, the numbers that they had projected to reach during Q4 of 2021 and Q1 of 2022, they did not meet that subscriber growth rate. They didn't meet that growth rate. They didn't come close to that growth rate. And it caused the stock to drop dramatically. It went from around $500 during market hours to around $400 after markets. That's a drop of $100 in a matter of around 10 minutes, guys. And a lot of people lost a lot of money holding onto Netflix, including me. But the great thing about that is that some of our people inside of the Discord, including myself, also seen that this dip was coming from Netflix in the streaming service platform. So for example, inside the Discord, one of our members put in the put option expecting that Netflix was not going to meet the expectations, and they came up big time, guys. Almost 500%. They made $9,000 in just one trade. In about 10 minutes of putting in that trade, they seen their account went from $1,000 to $9,000 in around 10 minutes. And the good thing about this is that you had just hedged your portfolios. But if Netflix would have met the expectations and it went up, you would have lost $1,000, but you would have still held on to your shares and made money while the stock went up. But since Netflix did drop, you would have lost a little bit of money holding on to your shares, but you would have made even more money putting in the option trade. And in this video, we're going to see if we could swing trade Netflix right on back up to the top. And there's also bonus stock at the end of this video, so make sure that you stick to the end of this video so you don't miss out on any crucial information. There's going to be a bonus stock at the end of this video to where we think that that stock might drop during that earnings call too, and it's coming up in February, guys. So make sure you subscribe to this channel so you don't miss out on that setup. So in this video, we're going to do a technical analysis on Netflix. We're going to look at some support and resistance lines and what we're planning on doing with Netflix in the future. And I'm also going to bring you guys that one bonus stock. Now, just remember, Netflix is not a bad company. The price did drop. They did raise their subscription service price. They did not meet expectations for subscriber growth rate. And there are other streaming platforms out there that is kind of stealing Netflix subscribers, like Disney, Amazon, Hulu, different streaming services out there that is kind of that Netflix has to compete with now. So in this video, we're just going to look at the technical analysis for Netflix and see how can we squeeze a little bit more money out of this downward trend on Netflix, and when can we see it eventually rebounding. But if you guys want to be a part of the trade, that $9,000 trade that happened over in the Discord, I'm going to leave a link down in the comment section to my Patreon. You click that, you sign up with Patreon, that'll link you to my Discord. Over there in the Discord, we post day trades every single day. I post swing trades, and I also post every single time I buy and sell a stock. I'm running the real strategy on a couple of stocks. I post swing trades, and then we have some great day traders in there, and you'll be a part of a great community so you can see trades just like that every single day inside the Discord. So if you want to sign up for that, that link is going to be down in the comment section. So yeah, come over and be a part of a great community. But before we dive into this video is brought to you by Webull. Sign up now by clicking the link down in the description. Deposit any amount of money. You could deposit one penny if you want to, guys, and you'll receive two free stocks valued up to $1,600. With those two free stocks, you could keep them inside the platform and decide to use it, or you could sell those two free stocks and withdraw all of your money. It's literally free money. Also, I'm gonna leave a link in the description to Coinbase. That is by far the easiest way to buy and sell cryptocurrency. And the last link is to Moomoo. You sign up with Moomoo, deposit $100, and you receive five free stocks valued up to $17,000. Once again, with those five free stocks, you could keep them inside the platform and decide to use it, or you could sell those five free stocks. It's free money, guys. If you want some free stocks, use those links down in the description. But enough talking, let's go ahead and dive straight into this video. Welcome back, dreamers. Here we are on Netflix, ticker symbol NFLX. We're over on TradingView. This is the 4-hour chart. Now, as you guys can see, let's zoom in right quick. So yeah, we was day trading. We was swing trading Netflix on the way up to the top. We had set it an uptrend line right here where this was support, and we just kept buying Netflix all the way up to the top. And then when it finally broke that support line right here, we predicted that Netflix was going to pull back to the support line of the 100 to the support line of the 200 EMA. Then it stayed around here for a little bit inside of the golden zone. Remember, guys, we love buying inside of the Fibonacci sequence inside of the golden zone. But then once it had broke the downtrend right here, we knew that Netflix was going to eventually pull back. And we had set this buy area right here where it was consolidating sideways. We had set a buy area at the $520 price point to $505 price point. So we did not buy Netflix anytime during this time period right here. We let it pull all the way back. We knew that was going to eventually come back to our buy zone, and it did. So we picked up a couple more shares of Netflix, a couple more fractional shares of Netflix. And then the earnings report came out, and we already seen that Netflix was in a downtrend. So a lot of our members inside the Discord predicted that Netflix was going to pull back from the earnings report. And God almighty, did it pull back. It jumped all the way from around $504 to around $398, the $400 price point. And a lot of people made a lot of money putting in a put option on Netflix inside of the Discord. Now what we're going to do, this is the 4-hour chart. We're going to get rid of all this and do a completely new technical analysis. But right here on the 4-hour chart, as you guys can see, the 200 EMA is about to cross the 300 MA. And once that cross down, that's going to show that Netflix is going to be pulling back for a while now. And you probably won't see another bull run until you see the green line cross the blue line again, just like I had did previously. So anytime you see Netflix green line crosses the blue line, you see it goes in somewhat of a bull run. So we have been in the $300 price points before. We have been in the $400 price points before. So it's going to probably be a while before we could swing trade Netflix on up to the top. But let's go ahead and switch over to the day chart, get rid of a couple of these lines so that we could do a technical analysis right quick. So we're going to change it from 4 hours to 1 day, and let's just get rid of this buy zone. Let's just get rid of everything right quick. All right, so this is the 1 day chart. As you guys can see, let's draw out a downtrend line for Netflix. It is an aggressive downtrend line right here. So let's draw that all the way out to June, May. There you go. So this is June, May. We're going to have a whole another earnings report before then. So this is a clear support area right here. Let's draw out a quick rectangle in this zone. It bounce, 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 bounce. So this is going to probably be a good resistance line right here between the $460, $473 price point. And then if we move all the way back, there was one more strong support in this area right here. So let's draw out one more line, and that is the current zone that we're in. So hopefully we can see Netflix bounce in between these two zones for a while until we get to the next earnings report during this downtrend line. If it breaks this downtrend line and breaks above, then we can see, we'll wait for the green line to cross the blue line, and then we'll be back in the bull run. But for now, I could definitely see Netflix pulling back some more, probably all the way to around in this zone right around here. In this zone right around in here. So that is, you could see Netflix either. So yeah, if we're going to keep our eye open, we're going to keep our eye open on the MACD. Wait for the MACD to cross back over. The RSI showing that it's oversold. But yeah, it could continue to trend all the way back down to this area right here, back to the 331. Right now, it is inside of a buy zone. It is $397 is a great price point to get for an entry level for Netflix if you're planning on holding this stock for the next 5 to 10 years. The $400 price point is a great price to get in on Netflix. Let's drop the Fibonacci scale right quick. Fibonacci retracement all the way from the bottom to the top. And as you guys can see, the golden zone would be around the $500 price point. That is the golden zone. That will probably show it that we're back in the bull run once it gets back inside of the golden zone. But let's move this back over so we can see the buy zones. And there we go, guys. So we're going to keep, this is a quick technical analysis. We're looking at the green MA line, the blue MA line. Let's jump over to the 4-hour chart. That's 3 hours. Let's jump over to the 4-hour chart. And so we're going to look at the green MA line, the blue MA line. This buy zone, and this support zone right here of around $327 and $315. And we're going to keep a very, very, very close eye over the next couple of weeks on this MACD line. Once it crosses over on the one-day chart, that might be time for us to start to swing back up to the top. But I could definitely see Netflix doing this, coming back up, bouncing. Back down, bouncing all the way down to a downtrend and bouncing off of that down support line. And I could definitely see Netflix bouncing off its down support line until we get to its next earnings support. Now, for all of you people that waited until the end of this video, let me show you the next stock that we think is going to not do so well during this earnings report. And that company is Walt Disney. As you guys can see, it is doing the exact same thing that Netflix was doing. It had an all-time high. It broke the support line. It's been pulling back ever since. Netflix earnings came out and it showed that the streaming services aren't doing too good right now. So they're predicting that Disney streaming services is not going to do good. And if we look at the one-day chart, their earnings report is coming up on February 9th, 2022. So right now, a lot of people are predicting that Disney is going to fall. Hopefully, over the next couple of weeks, Disney starts to trend back up so it can get way up here. And then the earnings report comes out. We're going to put in a put option and watch it drops. If it goes up, cool. Then we already got a couple of shares of Disney. But if it continues to drop all the way to this earnings report, then it's already kind of priced in. The price is already kind of priced in that it was going to drop, and it's probably not going to move that much. So we're going to keep a very close eye on Disney over in the Discord. If you guys want to join that link is going to be down in the comment section. But this is the next stock that we're going to play. Hopefully we can make a couple more $1,000 from this trade. If you guys want to be a part of that, go ahead and join the Patreon. And there we go, dreamers. Remember to always hedge your portfolio, set certain buy range. Don't only buy at the high. If a stock is overpriced, then just don't buy it. Wait for it to pull back, because eventually it is going to pull back, and that's where we go in. You set certain buy zones, you buy stocks in those zones. And right now, hopefully Netflix do pull back to our other buy zone so we could get Netflix at a cheaper price. We're going to keep a very close eye on Disney to see what kind of options we're going to put in on Disney. Who knows, by the time the earnings call come up, we might put in a buy call on Disney just because we're predicting that the price is going to go up. But for now, I kind of think that the price is going to go down on Disney during this earnings report. But yo guys, don't forget to pick up your two free stocks with Webull. It's literally free money. Subscribe to this channel and hit that thumbs up button. It helps out this channel more than you can even imagine, guys. But other than that, I'm Zeke, bringing you the Dream Green Show, and I'm out. Peace.